بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ومولانا محمد رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اهتدى بهداه رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي الحمد لله my beloved brothers and sisters once again we are together in this live program the series of we are within the series of the teaching in the topic of achieving tranquility through worship. And if you recall, in our last session we have just enlightened our own selves together about the importance of the Sakina through Al-Quran Al-Kareem. And we just, if you recall, if you are not able to have Sakina through Al-Quran, then don't expect to get Sakina in anywhere else. Because even if you got Sakina or tranquility in somewhere else because of wealth, because of any other things, it could be temporary. Because your life is linked to that matter you are connected to. Yani if you are get the Sakina and the happiness or calmness because of the wealth, if you lose that wealth, you lose the Sakina. If you lose your position, you lose that sakina. But Al-Quran Al-Kareem teach you how to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who have given you everything. And in case of there is anything happen in your life, if you lost these things, you will know that you lost them because of something going to be replaced also as well. Because Allah is the one who gave you all these things and He will replace it with better. This is who teaching us Al-Quran Al-Kareem. Al-Quran, we have explained about it and how Al-Quran and how Al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have taught the people about Al-Quran Al-Kareem, not by advices, but by looking to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as he was a best example to all of them, radiallahu anhum, and to all of us as well, alayhi salatu wa sallam. He was walking Quran, if you may say. When they asked Sayyidina Aisha radiallahu anha, about the akhlaq, the moral character of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, have you not read Al-Quran? They said, yes, ya Umm al-Mu'mineen. Yes, O mother of believers. She said, that is the akhlaq of Rasulullah. This is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He will be happy when we apply all our affairs to Al-Quran. And he's angry if we exceed the limit. Not because of we're going against the Quran or against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because you're going to lose. Allah won't lose anything subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't think that if you go and say again the Quran and Allah will be angry. Allah will be angry with you for your own sake. Because the Quran taught us how to be good. Therefore, we have to teach our self and our new generation to educate them about Al-Quran Al-Kareem, about the 114 surahs in Al-Quran Al-Kareem, the stories of Al-Quran, the examples of Al-Quran, the lessons of Al-Quran Al-Kareem, so that inshallah we will be blessed. And if you remember, we said that Al-Quran is your friend, is the best friend, because the friend, the companion, let's say, he's the one who will benefit you. He will give you his advice in a time of difficulties, and will be happy for you in a time of ease, and how he will teach you how to overcome the difficulties and how to deal with your eases and how to be good to others. You won't find someone in this world can give you these examples better than Al-Quran Al-Kareem. Therefore, Al-Quran is, as Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Shafi' Yashfa'. There is a special intercession for us through Al-Quran Al-Kareem. Therefore, as we said, it's not only recitation, but understand the meanings, interpretation, and apply it in our life for the best of dunya al-akhirah. When they said as-sahaba, radiallahu anhu, kanu waqafin, what that mean? They are a people whom when you say Al-Quran said, that's it, stop, full stop. No one can go against it. Because ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهُ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. How come you go against the Quran which be sent to you to guide you? So if you need guidance, If you ask someone of guidance, follow what he said. If not, you know, you will be in a trouble. And in the meantime, if you don't want guidance, don't ask. Because if you go against the guidance, the one who guided you, later on, if you say, well, I should have, you know, just listened to so-and-so or just, you know, followed his advices, but it'll be too late. It'll be too late. The Quran al-Kareem can, and you can understand that as a manhaj for life, is a schedule, is a something programs for your whole life, from morning when you wake up until you sleep, and even when you sleep and when you wake up and in between. So these all was, they were, you know, all these qualities, they were explained for all of us through Al-Habib sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. So now we have to try our best to be min ahlul Qur'an. If you are among those people whom they are ahlul Qur'an, they say the family of al-Qur'an, you won't lose. This is the best of families. This is the best of companions, if al-Qur'an your friend, your companion, because you won't lose at all. But and of course, you can see the Qur'an al-Kareem explaining to you special and beautiful meanings. Let me just go through some beautiful meanings in Al-Quran Al-Kareem. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he talk about successful success, he mentioned about success in three different meanings. One of them, Al-Fawz Al-Mubin, which is a clear success. Second one, Al-Fawz Al-Kabir, big success. Third one, Al-Fawz Al-Azim, great success. In brief, I just, because of the time, I will just go quickly to explain this. Al-Fawz Al-Mubin is when you are protected from Jahannam. You're no more, you know, you are Allah protected from Jahannam. You won't go to Jahannam, to hellfire. May Allah protect us. This is clear, you know, what you call it, success. For example, you're waiting for results, you know, and then they will say, you are not failed, don't worry. So you're relief, alhamdulillah, I'm not failed. So that you mean you are among the success. This is a clear success, we call it. So you're relief. Second, al-fawzul kabir, the big success. What's the big success here? When you go on Quran, if you read al-fawzul kabir, if you go and read this al-fawzul kabir, when you enter Jannah, inshallah. Let's say if you avoided it from being failure, from failed, that means you're success already. And you will know that you have got a good marks to be among those whom they are having good future. And our good future is Al-Jannah. We, you know, our great, our big future, big aim is to be, inshallah, among the people of Jannah. Third one, Al-Fawzul Azim, is the success. What is it? Is when you get the pleasant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah please with you, Allah, this is the best. This is the highest. This whole school, there are many people of success, many people who pass the exam. But maybe there is only one who's, they say, he's at top of the whole school. And there is, he is at top of all states. Or maybe you say, he's at top of all the countries, all the country. You know, number one, the best student. This is a great success. See, Fawzul Al-Mubin, Al-Fawzul Al-Kabir, and then Al-Fawzul Azim. But here, see what I did like that, clear, going smaller circle. No, but here, just be pleased with Allah. The circle is bigger, in fact, inshallah. Because Al-Fawzul Mubin, Al-Fawzul Azim, clear success and big success is within pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you please Allah, you will be avoided automatically from Jahannam. I will be automatically in Jannah and you will be closer to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is Al-Fawz, what? Al-Fawzul Azim. So the Quran al-Kareem explaining these meanings for all of us. If we know these meanings, we'll be happy. Therefore, al-mufassirin, those whom they really spend their life in tafsir al-Quran, because they want us to understand that al-Quran al-Kareem is something bigger than we thought, bigger than a book we read. It's not a book only we read who get its blessings. Is something great. Some manhaj is a way of life for success. Is a way of to overcome any problems in our life. But if there are some people who they just want to be blind this life, what to do? They have all their lives, you know, time to do that. But if they, at the end, they just want, because they are blind, they don't want to follow the guidance, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Isra, verse 72, مَنْ كَانَ فِي هَذِي يَعْمَى فَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ يَعْمَى وَأَضَلُّ سَبِيلًا. Which means whoever is blind in this life, yani his heart is blind, he's not following the guidance, whoever is blind in this life, he will be blind in the hereafter, and even more astray. May Allah protect us all. If you don't, never going to understand these meanings, what else? لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. May Allah protect us all. So brothers, sisters, this is something we have to do to get the sakina of Al-Quran Al-Kareem, inshallah, in our life. And as we said, read one page, read even one verse with its interpretation. And you will be happy. You will discover, you see, you have spent one full day, 24 hours, you did something good in your page of that day. So in the page of day, you are busy, you are like, you did something, so much things, maybe they are useless or nothing to do with increasing their level of iman, of humanity. You will find in that page at least one line, good line, very good line, where everyone looking to, you know, it is something which is great. One verse of Quran with its interpretation, that's great. Every day before you leave home, it won't take from you 2-3 minutes, and they are some of in our phones we have it. In the car we can also with its translation. Just put the phone in the car, listen to the Quran and its translation. And sometimes there's interpretation. So that's something which is beautiful and which is great. You can spend you will be happy at the end of the day because you did something at least make you happy and might bring tranquility for you, inshallah. Tayyib. Now there are things which we have to do, which is zikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we have now to go through to also something else, which is al-dhikr. Al-dhikr, as al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained to us, al-Quran al-Kareem, of course, and al-Hadith al-Sharif, the sayings of the blessed sayings of Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, explain to us so much of things. Example, beautiful pearls. He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a hadith narrated by Imam Muslim, narrated by Sayyidina Abu Huraira and Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, radiallahu anhuma, may Allah please be with them, reported that Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when a group of people assemble for the remembrance of Allah, the angels surround them with their wings. Allah's mercy envelops them with the sakina, or let's say tranquility, and sakina and tranquility upon them, descend upon them, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of them before those who are nearer to him, in the presence of those nearer. What we, this hadith is hadith about Al-Quran, and here hadith zikrullah. How to combine between both? The best zikr is Al-Quran al-Kareem. Inna nahnu nazzalna al-dhikra. We are the one who revealed al-dhikr. Al-dhikr here, Al-Quran. If you say alif, lam, mim is dhikr already. And the zikr also, whatever, you know, the azkar that you can see in Al-Quran al-Kareem, the zikr and the of Al-Anbiya al-Musaleen, La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimeen, inni masani al-dur wa anta arhamur rahimeen, hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakil, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. And these are azkar, and Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained to us about these. He interpreted the Quran to us about the meaning of this zikr in our life, and that will bring sakina for all of us. Example, Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in one of the narrations said, Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, we'll go to the narration, it's narrated by Sayyidina Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, that a man who was stung by a scorpion was brought to Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he alayhi salat wa salam sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he said the word, أعوذ بكلمات الله التامة من كل شيء من شر ما خلق. أعوذ بكلمات الله التامة من كل من شر ما خلق, which means he said, صلى الله عليه وسلم said, had he said the word, I seek refuge in the perfect words of Allah from the evil of what he created. He said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, لم يلدغ, he would not have been stung. He would be protected. Al-ulama said, if you roughly, you know, regularly do this zikr, this is al-adhkar, the very important one, by the way, أعوذ بكلمات الله التامة من شر ما خلق, always, always, and you have yaqeen that this is not a word you are reciting, it's a blessing you are getting from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, taught for us by Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will get that inshaAllah. One more hadith, narrated by and سيدنا عثمان بن عفان رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما من عبدي يقول في صباح كل يوم ومساء كل ليلة بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم ثلاث مرات فيضره شيء, which means سيدنا عثمان بن عفان رضي الله عنه وأرضاه said that رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said there is no worshipper, a believer, who says in the morning of every day and in the evening of every night, in the name of Allah, who with his name nothing in the earth or in the heavens can cause harm to me. And he is, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the hearing, the knowing. If he said that three times, he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, except that nothing shall harm him. Nothing shall harm him. Again, one more time, we recite this, the zikr. Bismillah alladhi la yadhurru ma'a ismihi shay'un fil ardi wa la fis sama'i wa huwa as-sami'ul 'alim. Just say that three times in the morning. Bismillah alladhi la yadhurru ma'a ismihi shay'un fil ardi wa la fis sama'i wa bismillah alladhi la yadhurru ma'a ismihi shay'un fil ardi wa la fis sama'i wa as-sami'ul 'alim. With the hope that, ya Allah, this is your words. This is something from you for protection. You have yaqeen. You have something in your heart saying, yeah, that's what you want, what you should do, then you will be protected. As-Sahaba, they took that seriously. And the Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they took that seriously and they applied it in their life. You won't see, they will sit after Salat Subuh. This is the best time, after Fajr, sit for this half an hour. Whatever azkar for the morning, أصبحنا وأصبح الملك اللهم بك أصبحنا وبك نحيا رضينا بالله تعالى. أذكار, it's available. It's there already. There is رواتب. راتب like سيدنا الإمام عبد الله بن علوي الحداد, he made it in راتب. راتب is called ورد اللطيف. ورد اللطيف. Very good. ورد اللطيف, that's for morning and evening. Beautiful. He combined all the ذكر from Al-Quran and from Al-Hadith al-Sharif of Sayyidina al-Mustafa صلى الله عليه وسلم. He made it in combined it to one and recited morning and evening. MashaAllah, it's full of barakah by awliya. And those awliya, when they got this by permission or by ijazat, of course, it's not just like that. You just try it and see, and it will take from you. If it's يعني, the most will take from you, if with difficulties and you just recite it nicely and slowly, it will take 20 minutes. If not, we take maybe 10 minutes. If you can't recite it, just, well, of course, to recite it is better because Sayyidina Ali say, man qala, if you say, but at least if you just listen to the recitation, it's available there. You know, it's available there in YouTube and many places, of course. Just listen to it, mashallah, it's very great, subhanAllah. You feel calmness in the house. If your children, you just after subuh, if you pray, inshallah, fajr together, ask them to listen to it. Listening 1 day, 2 day, 1 month, 2 months, they will memorize it. They can memorize very fast. Later on, you will see they can say it by themselves. We can do that also for ourselves. These are full of protection from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب, one more thing. See what Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. He said, kalimatani, two words, very simple, he said, because kalimatani, see how simple. Kalimatani, two words. Khafifatani al-lisan, very light if you say it. You know, خفيفتان, as if you say by your tongue, very light. ثقيلتان في الميزان, but very heavy in the scale of your goodness, in the scale of القيامة. When you know, if you buy gold, 1 gram is meaningful, of course. If you buy, if you sell that gold, the goldsmith, if you say, okay, this is 49 gram, you say, no, it's 50 gram, because that gram, 1 gram has meaning. And if they sell to you also less than what you want, is a problem. because and they charge you for 50 and they sell for you 49 gram, for example, you will fight for them. This is because of it's gold. These are the golds of dunya and akhirah, which poor and rich people can have. Al-Athkar, full of protection for you, for your family. You are not there. You cannot just protect them all the time. You are overseas, you know, you are there, you are here, and they are here, they may be there. But with this dhikr, if you teach them from now, and they, inshallah, there will be protection. So what these two words, which is light in your tongue, very heavy in your scale, and one more thing, habibatani lirrahman, very beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh, something very nice to say, right? Make Allah happy with you and your, that's we said, one page, if you say in your page, you will find one good thing, that page is khalas, there is a light on the whole page. What is it? Subhanallah wa bihamdih, subhanallah al-azim. Subhanallah wa bihamdih, subhanallah al-azim. So, subhanallah, just saying that, pleasing Allah already, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because beloved to him, subhanallah wa bihamdih, subhanallah al-azim. That when you did that, this sakina will come. Because you did something, you have said something which is beloved to Allah. And it's very light, very easy to say, right? Then you will find the barakah of it in the scale of your goodness is like what we say, the gold. If you are in a driving your car, going to office, and we mentioned this before, about, you know, we mentioned about about this before, like if you go to your office and it will take maybe half an hour driving, we say normally take half an hour, if no traffic, with traffic it will take 1 hour. Mm-hmm. Just recite this zikr, example. Subhanallah bihamdi, subhanallah al-azim. Can you imagine? Can you imagine in yawm al-qiyamah, in dunya of course, first of all, and yawm al-qiyamah you meet Allah, you'll be gathered among those whom Allah loves them. Because why? You used to recite what he loves, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Uh-huh. Sometimes there's a people, those days, there is a kings, those days in Arab, kings, they bring poets to recite poem. If one of them say one line of prose of poem, he will get the closest to that king and he will be among his advisor, because he said something that he liked, he loved. Now, we are not saying poem, we are not saying well, zikrullah, which protection for all of us, pleasing to him, and will be for us in dunya and in akhirah. This we have to understand it very carefully and very clearly, bi'idhnillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us go one more hadith, al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Say, wa'an summa, an samurata ibn jundub, رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم أحب الكلام إلى الله أربع لا يضرك بأيهن بدأت سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر narrated by Imam Muslim. Samura bin Jundub رضي الله عنه narrated that سيدنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said the words dearer to Allah are four. This one more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which are subhanallah walhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah wallahu akbar. How perfect Allah is, and all praise for Allah. None has the right to be worshipped except Allah alone, and Allah is great. He say, it does not matter which you say first. No problem, which one you start, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yeah, which one you start, if you say Alhamdulillah wa subhanallah, that's also, it's okay, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. See, we want to make it easy for us. But I don't think anyone in this, subhanallah, alhamdulillah, wa la ilaha, can miss that. After salat, subhanallah, subhanallah, subhanallah. Sayyidina Rasulullah taught Sayyidina Ali, when Sayyidina Fatima, she was very tired because she don't have a helper. And when Sayyidina Mustafa, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, came to her house and seated, and next to him, Sayyidina Fatima and Sayyidina Ali on his the other side, and he hold both hands. He said, I'm going to teach you something better that will help you a lot in your life. Better than a helper. She was helping to get helper. He said, better than helper. What is it? Subhanallah, 33 times. Alhamdulillah, 33 times. Allah Akbar, 33 times. And in the last, Subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la hawla wa la quwwata. And the last, the 34, wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-aliyyi al-azim. He said better. So they ask Sayyidina Ali, and you did it? He said, I never missed that. They said, even in the day where you're fighting, from day and night, you know, he said, I was riding my horse and fighting, and I was reciting that. Never, because it's granted. It's something came from the mouth of Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who never say anything by his own. وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيُّ يُوحَىٰ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ. So now, this beautiful, if we can do that. But the thing is, now, we used to say, all of us need changes in our life. And these are the things will change our life, inshallah. Will help us to enlighten our life. If we want to think carefully, by zikrullah, you will think. If you want to be good human beings, you will do that. If you want to discover something, you want to help in your business. If you are a doctor, Allah will bless you to do your best. You need power, you need energy. And these are the energies. Your people cannot give you that energy, of course. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided that, and you can be a believer, you can be good human beings, because zikrullah will keep you away from any falsehood, from any wrongdoings. Suppose that if we take it as physically and spiritually, if it affects us spiritually, affect our spirit. And that's how it's very important. So these are the changes through, and these are how we change. So many people want changes. But the question is, who wants to change? Who wants to do that? See, wallahi, many people always say, Ya Shaykh, I have this question. I have that one. I have this. I have that. I have. I can't. My sleeping is like that. My family. Akhi, this is a zikr. Recite, example. Then after some time, how is it? Still the same. Have you recited zikr? No. Ya Akhi, if you're not taking medicine, what should the doctor do for you? Spiritual. What to do? We have lots of problems, wallahi. But we are, as we said, very lazy to do zikr. Very lazy to pray on time. Very lazy. In the end of the day, we want jannat al-jari min tahti al-nahar. I want to be close to Allah, I want to be my, you know, I want to be close to you, and I want close to your Prophet, and. These things won't help like that. You have to practice this in your life. So Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us how to do this. This is a sakina. Tayyib. If we are a bit of lazy to do this, there is a solution for it. There is another remedy. There is a special remedy, medicine, to remove that. What is it? Of course, Allah said in the Quran, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. Ya Allah, to you alone we worship, and from you alone we need your help. To worship you, Ya Allah, we need your help. And it's not easy, of course. We are not saying that, of course, there are lots of things in your life will take you away from worship, from zikr. So what you should do? Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us one beautiful hadith also, in this beautiful hadith, where he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, listen to this hadith. This is something which we have really to focus on, this meaning of this hadith. The hadith narrated by Sayyidina Mu'adh bin Jabal radiallahu anhu. Sayyidina Mu'adh, one of those whom Sayyidina Rasulullah loves them special love. And in the hadith said that Sayyidina Mu'adh narrated, he said that one day Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took my hand. He held his hand, Ya Mu'adh, and he said to him, listen carefully, brother and sister, listen carefully. He said, Ya Mu'adh, I do indeed love you. Who's saying? Rasulullah. To whom? To Mu'adh. Allah, ajib. So when you love someone, you will give him whatever you want. Whatever he wants, whatever to please him, you will give him the best. You are very sincere, you will be very sincere for him, or to him. So Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam listened to this word. He said, Oh Mu'adh, I do indeed love you, and I advise you, Oh Mu'adh, okay? Because of my love, there is one good advice for you. Take it seriously. What is it? He said, not to ever, don't ever forsake saying, forget or ignore saying after completion of prayer, after salat, after salamu alaykum, say these things, these words. Say something. What is it? Allahumma anni ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatik. Allahumma anni ala dhikrika wa shukrika وحسني عبادتك, which mean he said don't ever leave this world, huh? صلى الله عليه وسلم, don't always after completion of your prayers after salat, he said, oh Allah, assist me in your remembrance and expressing gratitude to you and perfecting my worship to you. Ya Allah, oh Allah, assist me in your remembrance and expressing gratitude to you and perfecting my worship to you. A'inni ala dhikrik, shukrik, wa hasni ibadatik. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't ever lose saying that. But do you see the meanings of it? Ya Allah, give me the help. If you struggle to do that, to worship or to do zikr, you will find it easy because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're praying, you're asking Him, Iyaka na'budu wa Iyaka nasta'in, He will help you. It will come, bi'idhnillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you will be helped. You will be helped. So these are adhkar where you can, you know, sit and if you are alone, you can just recite it and you will feel happiness. Morning, evening, zikr, after each salah, what Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, like this zikr, like subhanallah, 33 times, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar. And these are something which is, you will bring for you, sakina, as al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. Now, طيب, if you do something after what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fara'id, five times, then you do nawafil, you do the zikr, you do this, what's going to happen? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you very special servant. How? In a hadith narrated by Imam Muslim, my Imam al-Bukhari, he said, an authority of Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Allah subhanahu, this hadith Qudsi we call it, hadith Qudsi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, whosoever shows enmity to a wali, waliya Allah the saint, of mine, then I have declared war against him. I have declared war against him. See, the special protection for awliya Allah. And immediately what Allah said, this is the hadith, continue. See, that means these awliya, through these they have reached to become awliya and therefore they got Allah's protection. And he said, and my servant does not draw near to me with anything more love to me than the religious duties I have obligated upon him. The best thing is what the fara'id Allah give you, five times your salat, whatever rites, whatever Allah has asked you to do, this is the most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But what else? He say, and my servant continues to draw nearer to me with nafil, with sunan, nawafil, the extras which Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us. You know, these extras, the sunan, yani sunan, salat, before salat, after salat. This is sunan, one of tahajjud, sadaqat. This is all something which is not obligatory, but it's you will find the benefit of it. Now we will discover it so shortly. There's one beautiful saying, of course, about the sunan. He said, I went to majlis of Al-Imam Muhammad Mitwalli Sha'rawi, rahimahullah. Great allama, great mufassir al-Quran. His tafsir Quran, they call it the inspiration of Al-Sha'rawi, because so beautiful. And the people really likes it. And there thousands of people got benefited from him through his Quran interpretation. Alhamdulillah. So he said, I want to visit him. He was an imam, one of the students in Al-Azhar. He said, I want to visit Al-Imam, and he was waiting. And it was a Salat Asr. So he asked me, yeah, good that you came, Azan. So I Azan. Then he said, okay, let us pray Sunnah. Said, ya Imam, pray Sunnah or Iqama straight away. He said, no, he let us pray Sunnah. So we pray the Sunnah. After praying Sunnah, he said, now let us do the Fard, you be our Imam. So I did that, I became also the Imam. And then Imam Sha'rawi said to him, as Sunnah by whom? He asked me, he said, Sunnah introduced to us by whom? They said, by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Say, and a fard by whom? Say, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, if thou, through the sunnah, you are entering to the father, fard. To Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you're entering to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The sunnah, al-Quran, subhanallah, beautiful explanation. This is sunan which we never care for them. They has great meanings. And listen carefully. Listen carefully. They say, my servants continue to draw near to me with nafil deeds until I love him. With nafil. Because obligatory, everyone will do. But nafil, people are not, yes, no, yeah, it's not, it's only sunnah. Yes, it's sunnah. Sunnah, you won't be punished. Yeah, but you lose the reward. And we are in need for reward. Yani someone say, yeah, fulan, brother, this is $1 million for you. You will take the only and say, hey, but there's 1,000 also. You want to take it? You will say, no, I don't want. No, of course I want. Yeah, it has a... this is something which no need to, you know, even if you have one box of gold, of let's say gemstones, 100 of them, one fell, you will take it. You won't leave it. So now we have lots of things, beautiful things. So what he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said in the hadith Qudsi, he said, my servants continue to draw near to me with nafil deeds until I love him. Then, ya Allah, what is after Allah's love? What if Allah loves one of us? Let's say, if we are Ahl Nawafil, if we do Nawafil, inshallah, what's going to happen? He's saying, when I love him, I am his hearing with which he hears. He will hear through me. We'll explain about this now. And I will be his sight with which he sees, and his hand with which he strikes, and his foot with which he walks. But that means you are, because of your ibadah, because of you engage yourself totally in remembrance of Allah, in worshipping Allah, Allah won't allow you, he will give you a special dosage of protection that you won't hear, you would dislike to hear anything wrong. If you see, I don't want to listen, please don't talk like that. This joke is racist joke. This something lie. This is backbite. I don't want to hear, please. Not to say, hey, please give me more. I want to listen more. No protection. No protection. If you see something, you know. If you're not unpleasing to Allah, you won't see it. You don't want to see it. Huh? And you won't do with your hand anything wrong. You won't walk to something somewhere which is wrong with Allah's protection. And these are what the level of awliya. Who is waliullah? Those whom Allah protect them and declare wars against those whom they fight them. How they reach to Allah? By fara'id, they very concerned about it. Obligatories, and by the sunan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them very special dosage. These are the barakah of zikrullah, brothers, sisters, and barakah of nafil, brava, and the blessing of extra in our life. Yani, an example. Sayyidina Bilal. Sayyidina Bilal, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said about him, ya Bilal, inform me about some things you used to do, because I've heard the sound of your sleeper in Jannah. Meaning when someone walk from somewhere, because we used to, you know, like my mother or my father or someone walk, we know that he's coming from the way he walk. So, ajib. So, when he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I hear that, you know, in Jannah, the stack you are. So, what you used to do? He said, ya Rasulullah, wherever I take wuzu, I apply my wuzu, ablution, I will just pray two rak'ah nafl. Nafl, two rak'ah, sunnah, Allah Akbar, very light. Inna atainaka al-kawthar, qul huwa Allah ahad. That's it. Yes, I do that. See, we say that now, easy. But tell me who can do that always. Because of that, Sayyidina Bilal knows, subhanAllah, Sayyidina Rasulullah asks, he have to answer. And he knows this is something which is an extra thing he used to do to please Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And because of that, Sayyidina Rasulullah said, I hear the sound of your sleeper in Jannah. You're walking, that means, the way you walk in Jannah. Ajib. If you do that, and you add some other things to that, Allah won't forget. وَمَا كَانَ رَبُّكَ نَسِيًّا. Don't think Allah will forget. Never. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا. Little bit. You do. خَيْرًا يَرَى. He will see the goodness of it. وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never forgot the water which that lady gift to the thirsty dog. You think Allah will forget your good deeds? No. Allah won't give you a good result for your remembrance? No. Don't think people, sometimes people think negatively about this life, and because of that they got disturbance. If you just really stop thinking about this and that, and be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and do whatever is good you can do, you are protected. Don't think about this. Don't think, oh, this person wants to harm me. That one wants to do this. This one, the jinn is coming to my house. Now we have this story. Someone little bit, he have little bit of hadith. He say, maybe I have jinn in my, shayateen. If something, I lost this. لا حول ولا قوة. Where is your connection with Allah? Remember, الفوز العظيم. The greatest success, what? Ridwanillah, when Allah pleased with you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do whatever makes Allah pleased with you, with your sincerity, and you will find the greatest result, inshallah, results in all the matters of your life. But if you're lazy and you just listen and ignore it, don't expect you get the sakina. The sakina will come when we enter our house, say, salam alaikum. Our children, salam, peace be upon you, Allahu Akbar. When you eat bismillah, And when we say Alhamdulillah, and when we pray, this is something very great. Shaytan, when enter house, we say Salam alaykum, always zikr. And a shaytan won't eat with you the same meal you eat, the same food when you eat, and you mention Allah's name. But if no salam, no remembrance of Allah, no zikrullah when you eat, a shaytan will say to his fellow, we have got food and staying, full board, yani. And he said, well, sister, these are something you think is simple, but it's not. It's very important. But you'll find the differences if you start doing it in your shape. This is a physical shape, but you'll find it. You will shape now your spirituality. We are looking to shape ourselves, or decorate ourselves, our shape. But there's a special shape. Spirituality has special shape. You have to shape your spirituality, and this spirituality is the one who connects you with Allah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah looking to the hearts which is unseen and unknown what is inside them. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will fix it and He will make you among those whom they are blessed bi-idhnillah subhanahu wa ta'ala with this full barakah in your life and in the hereafter. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us this barakah fi al-deen wa al-dunya wa al-akhirah. May He keep us protected. And let me just end with, there are five important things in our life, brothers and sisters, we have to do. Don't ever let the life steal from you these five things. Number one, a moment of purity with your Lord, subhanahu wa ta'ala. A remembering of Allah, sitting, remembering Him, saying the words which He loved, His beloved, subhanallah bi'amdi, doing something that He loved, saying something that He loved, acting in a way He loves, subhanahu wa ta'ala. This we call a moment of purity with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, fulfill piety of your try to be the best, to try to do the best to your parents, because after pleasing Allah, it's your parents to be pleased. And if you please Allah with Allah's help, whatever is there, any far distance between you and your parents, or between you and your parents, this far distance because of the hearts, Allah will make it close. Allah will ease it, and will be, that distance will be closer, you will be closer, closer. No more far distance, and you see how Allah clear it for you. You are enabled, because we have lots of issues and problems. And this we'll discuss, later we'll talk about the sakina among families. You know, but if we try pleasing Allah and trying to do this, inshallah Allah will help us. So don't let the life steal from you this matter. Because life, why we say the life? Life is short. And if you're losing this, it won't come back again. And these are one of the things which cannot be replaced. Pleasing your parents. That this is something only if they come back to the life. And that's impossible. So you have to do that. These, don't let the life steal this from you. Love for your family. Love is what? To give them the best. And the best you give them is to make them close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya alladhina amanu qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara. Protect yourself and your family from Jahannam. How to protect from Jahannam? By having taqwa, by doing something good for you and for everyone, so that your family will be good after you, inshallah, or together with you. Doing good to those around you. Don't expect from them to do good, but you do the good for them. There is one lady, she asked her neighbor, she sent one of the children to get from their neighbor, whom they're very poor family, very poor. She asked for salt. Salt. Something very cheap, very, you know, everyone in the house. For sure there will be salt and water in the house. You know, so she asked one of the children to go and get salt from her neighbor. So her son, he said, "Mother, why you ask for salt? We are, alhamdulillah, we have, I think, a few kgs of salt here. And, you know, what's the reason?" She said, "I know we have salt. These, our neighbor, always, sometimes they ask us for help because they are very poor. So I don't want them to feel that we are, feel a bit unhappy with their ask. So I want to feel that there is an exchange. Also, I'm asking you for something. You are not favoring, I'm not favoring you. We are not favoring. This is why we have to do something which is as an exchange, this one. So the easiest I can get from them is a salt. Subhanallah. Ajeeb. What is this? Pleasing those around you. Under, maybe around you because the easiest, but there are some people, they're far away from you. He doesn't know. He doesn't know. Someone who's very far and you know he's in a problem, he's across the border, maybe you can't travel to see him, but you can please him while you are there. He's in a trouble, send him message, send him something, deposit something to his account. Say in this one, from so and so with love, with sincerity. Allah, this is something which really will, it has its strong impact in his life. Now, Tayyib, last, sincerity in whatever you do. For these four, all pleasing Allah, pleasing your family, love for your pleasing your parents, love your family, doing good to those around you. The last thing, sincerity. For these four, you need sincerity, ikhlas. Let your deeds be with sincerity, not in return. Innama nut'imukum liwajhi Allah, for the sake of Allah. And expect the goodness in this life from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and in the akhirah from him as well. May Allah grant us full barakah, protection, الخير في الدين والدنيا والآخرة. اللهم اجعلنا من عبادك الصالحين هداة مهتدين لا ضالين ولا مضلين وارض عنا بما رضيت بين عبادك الصالحين. اللهم اجعلنا من أهل الصفاء واجعلنا من البر واجعلنا من المحبة واجعلنا من أهل صلة الأرحام واجعلنا من عبادك الصالحين واجعلنا من المخلصين يا أرحم الراحمين. يا الله bless us with a moment of purity with you, a moment of sincerity and good relationship with our parents, with our families, with our neighbors, with our friends, with all humanity. And let us, Ya Allah, be sincere servants of yours. Let us be among those who they understand the Quran, they understand Zikrullah, and practice it in their life for the best of dunya and akhirah. And we ask you, Allah, to protect us from the ummah, all humankind, from all types of bala and diseases. Allahumma makshif anna al-bala wal-waba wal-ahat wal-afat wal-amrad wal-asqam wal-mihal fitan ma'ad wal-matan. Allahumma Allahumma fa'innaka bina rahim wa la tu'adzibna Allah fa'innaka alayna qadir wal-tub bina bil-ataf latif lutfika al-khafiyya latifi alim ya khabir. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana fi al-akhirati hasana wa qina azab al-nar waj'alna min ibadika al-akhyar al-muttaqin al-abrar ya azim ya kareem ya rahman al-dunya wal-akhirah. وصلي وسلم مبارك على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم والحمد لله رب العالمين. Brothers and sisters, جزاكم الله خير. And I will have one request. Request is, if you have any ideas, if you have something which is can benefit us, benefit all brothers and sisters in our classes regarding this topic, please don't hesitate. Send message, ask or enlighten us. We are all of us in need for hope in our life. Let us all be lights. You have light, this have light all. So you see our light already is delighted bi-idhnillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Put in your mind that you are part of this world. You created this world for a reason. And because of that, you has a great value. And inshallah, you benefit yourself, benefit others by the blessings of Allah. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.